ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
నెక్స్ట్ కంటిన్యూషన్ టు ది లాస్ట్ క్లాస్ దట్ ఈస్ ది స్ట్రక్చర్ ఆఫ్ ది స్పోరోజాయిట్. డెఫినెట్లీ స్పోరోజాయిట్ ఈజ్ infective stage. It is the infective stage of the plasmodium from person to person. It is with the sickle shape. Definitely sickle shape means like this. It is with the sickle in shape. This sporozoite is with the sickle shape. It is with the 15 microns in length. Definitely length means this is the length, this is the width. Definitely this is said to be as the length. This is the length, this is the width. Length of the sporozoite is about 15 microns. Width is 1 micron. 1 micron in width. Width nothing but thickness. This sporozoite is about 1 micron in width, 15 microns in length. Then when we observe this sporozoite, what is the shape of this sporozoite means, just assume this is the sporozoite. This is the sickle shape. Definitely both anterior, posterior ends are with the pointed. This is the anterior, this is the posterior, they are with the pointed. Middle part is with the swelling. Anterior, posterior ends are with the pointed. Middle part is with the swelling. Definitely in the anterior, whatever the cup shape depression which is present, that is said to be as the apical cup. Again, definitely into the apical cup, whatever the organelles which are gets open, that organelles are said to be as the secretory organelles. Secretory organelles, they are two in number. Definitely into the anterior apical cup, as we are discussing earlier, two secretory organelles are gets open. These two secretory organelles secrete cytolytic enzymes to definitely enter this sporozoite into the RBC, to definitely enter this sporozoite into the liver cell inside of the human body. This cytolytic enzymes are a lot useful. Cyto means cell, lytic means destruction. Definitely this cytolytic enzymes useful to the sporozoite to destruct membrane of the RBC or membrane of the liver cell to enter into them. In that way, anteriorly it is with a cup that is said to be as the apical cup. Definitely into that kind of the apical cup, secretory organelles are gets open. They secrete the cytolytic enzymes. Again, entire body of this sporozoite is covered with the pellicle. This is the elastic membrane. Pellicle is said to be as the elastic membrane.
In the pellicle, just assume this is the pellicle. This is the pellicle, that is nothing but elastic membrane.
In the case of the pellicle,
microtubules are present. Microtubules are present. These microtubules are principally useful to cause the wriggling moment. Definitely wriggling moment.
What is the meaning of the wriggling moment? Means zigzag moment. Non-directional moment is said to be as the wriggling moment. If this moment may not follow a definite direction, then that is said to be as the wriggling moment, that is the zigzag moment. Definitely this is also called as the zigzag moment. In the case of the pellicle, whatever the microtubules, these are the microtubules which are present. That microtubules principally useful to cause the zigzag moment, to cause the wriggling moment. Zigzag moment or wriggling moment is nothing but non-directional moment. Again, in the cytoplasm,
definitely nucleus is present. Again, Golgi complex is present. Again, mitochondria is also present in the case of the cytoplasm.
This is said to be as the mitochondria. Again, this is the ribosome. This is the ribosome. This is the endoplasmic reticulum. In that way, all kind of the organelles are present in the cytoplasm. Golgi complex is present, ribosomes are present, endoplasmic reticulum is present, mitochondria are present in the case of the cytoplasm here. In the cytoplasm also, many folded microtubules are present, many convoluted microtubules are present, but their function is still now unknown. In the cytoplasm also, many convoluted tubules, highly folded tubules are present, but their function is still now unknown. But whatever the microtubules which are present in the pellicle, whatever the microtubules which are present in the pellicle, that microtubules useful to cause the zigzag moment or wriggling moment. Zigzag moment or the wriggling moment. This kind of the moment is said to be as the zigzag moment or wriggling moment. To cause the zigzag moment or the wriggling moment, microtubules which are present in the pellicle are a lot useful. What is the pellicle means? The skin-like membrane which is present around to the sporozoite, that skin-like membrane is said to be as the pellicle, that is with the elasticity nature, that is with the microtubule. With the help of the microtubule, this pellicle causes the wriggling moment or the zigzag moment. Definitely non-directional moment, directionless moment is said to be as the zigzag moment or the wriggling moment. That is very clearly appeared in the case of the sporozoite. Again, who explained this structure of the sporozoite means Garnham. Garnham explained this structure of the sporozoite. Structure of the sporozoite was explained by the Garnham. Next to life cycle of Plasmodium. Next one is the life cycle of the Plasmodium.
Next conjugation is the life cycle of Plasmodium vivax. Definitely, as per previous information, Plasmodium completes its life cycle in two different species of the host. So that only it is said to be as the digenetic parasite. Plasmodium is said to be as the digenetic parasite because it completes its entire life cycle in two different species of the host. So that only it is said to be as the digenetic parasite. Then what are the two different species of the host? One is said to be as the female Anopheles mosquito. This is said to be as the primary host. Because in the female Anopheles mosquito, this Plasmodium completed its sexual life cycle. So that only that is said to be as the primary host. Again, man is said to be as the secondary host. Man is said to be as the secondary host because in the man a sexual life cycle is completed. In the man a sexual life cycle of Plasmodium is completed. So that only man is said to be as the secondary host. Again, in the case of the man, what kind of the asexual reproduction which is occurs in man means that is said to be as the zygogony. That is said to be as the zygogony or multiple fission. Multiple fission or asexual reproduction, that is the zygogony, is occurs in the case of the man. Definitely man is the secondary host to the Plasmodium because asexual reproduction of the Plasmodium such as the zygogony or the multiple fission is completed in the man. So that only man is said to be as the secondary host. Then what is the zygogony? What is the multiple fission? Means if the mother body can be divided into many daughters, if the mother body is divides into many daughters, then we can say that is the zygogony or the multiple fission. Again, in the case of the man, whatever the asexual reproduction such as the zygogony which is completed, that phase is said to be as the human phase. In the case of the man, whatever the asexual reproduction of the Plasmodium such as the zygogony is completed, that phase is said to be as the human phase. The complete life cycle of the Plasmodium in human, the complete asexual reproduction of the Plasmodium which is completed in the human is collectively called as the human phase. Definitely, whatever the sexual life cycle of the Plasmodium which is completed in mosquito, that is said to be as the mosquito phase. Sexual life cycle which is completed in mosquito of Plasmodium, that is said to be as the mosquito phase. This is said to be as the human phase. Asexual reproduction of Plasmodium such as the zygogony which is completed in the human, that is said to be as the human phase. Definitely in the human phase again, zygogony, that is the asexual reproduction, that is the multiple fission which is occurs in liver cell. Means definitely in the case of the human,
Again, this zygogony, this multiple fusion of the plasmodium is completed in both the liver as well as the RBC cells. Definitely, asexual reproduction of the plasmodium in the human is occurs in liver cell as well as in RBC cells also. Means definitely this zygogony are of two types. One is the hepatic zygogony. Hepatic zygogony. Second one is said to be as the erythrocytic. Erythrocytic zygogony. Erythrocytic zygogony, hepatic zygogony. Hepatic means liver cell. Hepatology. Study of liver. Study of liver is said to be as the hepatology. So you should remember, hepato means liver. Hepatic means liver cell. Inside of the liver cell, whatever the multiple fusion of the plasmodium which is occurs, that is said to be as the hepatic zygogony. Inside of the liver cell, whatever the multiple fusion of the plasmodium which is completed, that is said to be as the hepatic zygogony. Means definitely in liver cells, this hepatic zygogony is completed. Second one is the erythrocytic zygogony. Erythrocyte means red blood cell, that is the RBC. Erythros means red, cyte means cell, red blood cell, that is nothing but RBC, that is nothing but erythrocyte. Erythro means red, cyte means cell, red colored blood cell, that is said to be as the RBC. Definitely erythro means RBC, cytic zygogony means inside of the RBC cell, whatever the life cycle of the plasmodium which is completed, inside of the RBC, whatever the asexual reproduction of the plasmodium which is completed, that is said to be as the erythrocytic zygogony. Again, in hepatic zygogony, again two phases are there. In hepatic zygogony, again two phases are there. One is the free erythrocytic cycle. Second phase is the exoerythrocytic cycle. Again, in the case of the hepatic zygogony, so again in the case of the hepatic zygogony, the first phase is a free erythrocytic cycle, second phase is the exoerythrocytic cycle. In hepatic zygogony, again two phases are there. One is said to be as the free erythrocytic cycle, second one is the exoerythrocytic cycle. Of this, first one is the free erythrocytic cycle. Means whatever the asexual reproduction of the plasmodium which is occurs in the liver cell, that is again are of two phases. One is the free erythrocytic cycle, second one is the exoerythrocytic cycle. First, free erythrocytic cycle. Free erythrocytic cycle. Then, how this free erythrocytic cycle is gets begin, how it is gets begins means, whenever A female Anopheles mosquito, which is rich with the sporozoids. Whenever female Anopheles mosquito, which is rich with the sporozoids in its body, bites a healthy person for sucking of the blood, during that 2000 sporozoids are entered into the blood of the healthy person during the mosquito biting. Definitely, whenever the mosquito bites our body, during that mosquito releases its saliva into our blood. During the biting of mosquito, mosquito releases saliva into our blood to prevent blood clotting for easy sucking of the blood. So in this case also, whenever the female Anopheles mosquito bites a healthy person, which is rich with the sporozoids in his blood, whenever that bite a healthy person, definitely that sporozoids releases into the blood of the person during that period. Means during every biting of female Anopheles mosquito, how many number of these sporozoids are entered into the human body? Means 2000. 2000 sporozoids are reaches into the blood of the human during the mosquito biting. Here very important, whenever there is the chance to transfer the sporozoids into the blood of the human, means whenever the female Anopheles mosquito, which is with the sporozoids, that kind of the mosquito, if it can be bite a healthy person for sucking of the blood, during that, from the mosquito, 2000 sporozoids are released into the blood of the human. That sporozoids immediately begins a free erythrocytic cycle. Whenever the 2000 sporozoids are entered into the human blood, whenever the 2000 sporozoids are reaches into the blood of the healthy person, within half an hour, as per the Short and Garnham, within half an hour, this sporozoites entered into the liver through the bloodstream. Definitely, whenever this 2000 sporozoites reaches into the blood of the person during the mosquito biting, this 2000 sporozoites immediately may not be reaches into the liver. Within half an hour, they reaches into the liver from the bloodstream. Means definitely within half an hour means after immediate enter into the human body, they circulate for about half an hour in the blood of the person. After half an hour, they reaches into the liver. They entered into the liver cell to begin the free erythrocytic cycle. Then how they begin the free erythrocytic cycle after half an hour means, definitely within half an hour they reaches into the liver cell. Just assume this is the liver cell. This is the hepatocyte. This is said to be as the hepatocyte. This is the liver cell. At first, this sporozoid attaches to membrane of liver cell. This is the sporozoid. Within half an hour, as per the Short and Garnham, within half an hour, this sporozoids reaches to the liver and a single sporozoite is attached to the membrane of the hepatocyte, that is the liver cell. Then immediately sporozoite secrete cytolytic enzyme onto the liver cell membrane. Immediately with the help of the secretory organelle, this sporozoite secrete cytolytic enzymes
cytolytic enzymes. Definitely, sporozoite secrete cytolytic enzymes onto the liver cell membrane. By that way, liver cell membrane is ruptured. By that way, this sporozoite very freely entered into the liver cell. This sporozoite is very freely entered into the liver cell. Inside of liver cell, at first it transport into the rounded. Inside of the liver cell, this sickle shaped strophozoite is transformed into the rounded. This stage is said to be as the trophozoite. This phase is said to be as the trophozoite. Definitely, whenever the sporozoite is attached to the liver cell membrane, immediately it secretes cytolytic enzymes onto the liver cell membrane. By that way, liver cell membrane is ruptured here. Then sporozoite freely entered into the liver cell. Inside of the liver cell, that will be transformed into rounded form. That is said to be as the trophozoite. Trophozoite means this form starts feeding on the content of liver cell. This trophozoite form starts feeding on the content of the liver cell. So that only we can say tropho. Wherever the word tropho is there, that means that starts feeding on the content of this cell. Here also trophozoite state starts feeding on the content of the liver cell. So that is the trophozoite stage. Later, this trophozoite increases in size by feeding on the content of the liver cell. Definitely, this trophozoite increases in size by feeding on the content of the liver cell. This phase is said to be as the Sejeant stage. Whenever the trophozoite starts feeding on the content of the liver cell, then trophozoite increases in size, then that is said to be as the Sejeant. Then in the Sejeant, whatever the nucleus which is present, that nucleus undergoes repeated and repeated mitotic divisions. Nucleus which is present in the Sejeant stage, that nucleus undergoes the repeated and repeated mitotic division. By that way, about 12,000 daughter nuclei are formed. Definitely, after increasing the size of the trophozoite, then this phase is said to be as the Sejeant. Inside of the Sejeant, whatever the nucleus which is present, this nucleus undergoes repeated and repeated mitotic division to produce about 12,000 daughter nuclei. After getting the formation of the 12,000 daughter nuclei, cytoplasm also gets divides into 12,000 cytoplasmic pieces. After getting the formation of the 12,000 daughter nuclei, cytoplasm also gets divides into 12,000 cytoplasmic pieces. Later, each and every piece encloses a nuclei. Each and every piece encloses a daughter nuclei. By that way, daughter cells are formed. So definitely in the Sejeant, nucleus at first undergoes the repeated and repeated mitotic division to produce 12,000 daughter nuclei. After getting the formation of the 12,000 daughter nuclei, cytoplasm also gets divides into 12,000 cytoplasmic pieces. Each and every cytoplasmic piece later encloses with a daughter nuclei.
by that way daughter cells are formed here. Later, whenever the hepatic cell membrane, so whenever the liver cell membrane is ruptured, then whenever the Sejant membrane is ruptured, then this daughter cells, are releases into blood of the liver. Blood of the liver is said to be as the sinusoids. What is the meaning of this sinusoid? The blood filled space in liver, inside of the liver, whatever the areas which are filled with the blood, they are said to be as the sinusoid. Blood filled areas inside of the liver is said to be as the sinusoid. Blood filled areas in the liver are called as the sinusoid. Definitely, whenever the Sejant is ruptured, whenever the liver cell membrane is ruptured, then this daughter cells are releases into the blood filled space of liver, that is said to be as the sinusoid. This kind of the daughters are said to be as the cryptozoids. These are said to be as the cryptozoids. Due to the rupturing of liver cell, finally whatever the daughters which may be releases, they are said to be as the cryptozoids. These are about 12,000 in number. 12,000 in number. Definitely, within how many days this cryptozoites are releases from the liver cell after entering of this sporozoite into the liver cell, means after 8th day. Definitely, for completion of this entire life cycle, for completion of this entire life cycle in the liver cell, how many days are required? Means 8 days. Means within 8 days or at end of the 8th day, after entry of the sporozoite into the hepatocyte, this cryptozoites, 12,000 cryptozoites are released into the sinusoids of liver. They are said to be as the cryptozoite. They are 12,000 in number. This cycle is said to be as the free erythrocytic cycle. This entire is said to be as the free erythrocytic cycle. This is said to be as the free erythrocytic cycle. From the entry of the sporozoite into the hepatocyte to release of the cryptozoites from the liver cell is said to be as the free erythrocytic cycle. This is completed within 8 days. For completion of the free erythrocytic cycle, what is the duration which is taken place? Means 8 days. From the entry of the sporozoite into the hepatocyte up to release of the cryptozoites from the liver cell, what is the duration which is required? Means for about 8 days. Within 8 days, these cryptozoites are finally released from the infected liver cell into the blood filled space of the liver, that is nothing but sinusoid. Sinusoid, nothing but blood filled space. Again, this cryptozoids are also called as the first generation merozoids. Cryptozoids also called as first generated merozoids. These are also called as the first generated merozoites or cryptozoids. This cryptozoites again may be entered into the RBC to begin the erythrocytic cycle. For example, if this cryptozoite is entered into the RBC, then RBC cycle is begin. Otherwise, if this cryptozoite again entered into new hepatocyte, then exoerythrocytic cycle is begin. Definitely,
If this cryptozoite, if it is entered into the liver cell, then exoerythrocytic cycle, that is the second phase of the hepatic cytogonies, begin. Otherwise, if this cryptozoite is entered into the, infected into the RBC, definitely erythrocytic cycle is gets a begin. Means what I am saying is that cryptozoites have two options. Cryptozoites have two options. One, they may be infected to healthy liver cell to continue to begin exoerythrocytic cycle, or this cryptozoite may be entered into the RBC to begin the erythrocytic cycle. Definitely these cryptozoites have the two options. One, they may be infected to healthy liver cell to begin the exoerythrocytic cycle. Second, they may be infected to the RBC to begin the RBC cycle. So for example, if they may be infected to healthy liver cell, if they may be infected to healthy liver cell, then exoerythrocytic cycle is begin. Exoerythrocytic cycle, that is the second phase of hepatic cytogony. First phase of the hepatic cytogony is the free erythrocytic cycle, that will be completed within 8 days. Second phase of the hepatic cytogony is the exoerythrocytic cycle. If cryptozoites, if they may be infected to the healthy liver cell, then second phase, that is the exoerythrocytic cycle, is gets begin. Definitely if this cryptozoite infected to, this is the cryptozoite infected to the healthy hepatocyte. Healthy hepatocyte means new liver cell. Definitely it begins the exoerythrocytic cycle. Definitely inside of liver cell, again this cryptozoite is transformed into trophozoite like this. This is said to be as the trophozoite. Means after entering this cryptozoite into the hepatocyte, into the new hepatocyte, into healthy hepatocyte, inside of the new hepatocyte, cryptozoite starts feeding on the content of the liver cell. Then that phase is said to be as the trophozoite. Later here also, due to the feeding on the content of the liver cell, definitely here sporozoite is at first transformed into trophozoite in this phase. Means wherever the trophic word is mentioned, that means that starts feeding on the content of the liver cell. Definitely here also, merozoite after entering into the, cryptozoite after entering into the new liver cell, inside of the new liver cell, that also starts feeding on the content of the liver cell. Then that's also called as the trophozoite. Definitely this trophozoite increases in size due to the feeding on the content of the liver cell continuously. This trophozoite again increases in size due to the continuous feeding on the liver cell. Then this is also called as the cyzoite. Like that of this phase, here also this is said to be as the cyzoite. In this case also, trophozoite increases in size by feeding on the content of the liver cell again. That is said to be as the cyzoite. Here also, nucleus which is present in the cyzoite undergoes the repeated and repeated mitotic division. And by that way, many daughter nuclei are formed here also. So definitely after getting the formation of this cyzoite, nucleus which is present in the cyzoite also undergoes
repeated and repeated mitotic divisions to form the many daughter nuclei.
After that, cytoplasm undergoes the division and form the many cytoplasmic pieces.
Later, each and every cytoplasmic piece encloses a daughter nuclei to form the daughter cells. After getting the formation of the many daughter nuclei, this cytoplasm also undergoes divisions and form the cytoplasmic pieces. Each and every cytoplasmic piece encloses a daughter nuclei. By that way, daughter cells are formed. Later, this liver cell is ruptured. Later, this zygote membrane is ruptured. By that way, this daughter cells are released into the blood of the liver, that is said to be as the sinusoid. Here also, after getting the rupturing of the liver cell, after getting the rupturing of the zygote, this daughter cells are gets releases into the blood filled space, that is said to be as the sinusoid. This is said to be as the sinusoid. Definitely here also, after rupturing of the liver cell membrane, after rupturing of the zygote, definitely this daughter cells are releases into the blood filled space of liver, that is said to be as the sinusoid. This daughter cells are said to be as the metacryptozoids. Definitely at the end of the free erythrocytic cycle, whatever the daughters which are releases, they are said to be as the cryptozoids. But at the end of the exoerythrocytic cycle, this is said to be as the exoerythrocytic cycle. From this onwards to this, this cycle is said to be as the exoerythrocytic cycle. This is the exoerythrocytic cycle. This is the free erythrocytic cycle. From this onwards to this, this is said to be as the free erythrocytic cycle. At the end of the free erythrocytic cycle, daughters which may be releases, they are said to be as the cryptozoids. From this onwards to this, this entire is said to be as the exoerythrocytic cycle. What are the differences between these two? Exoerythrocytic cycle begins with the cryptozoids entering. Exoerythrocytic cycle begins with the cryptozoite infection. But free erythrocytic cycle begins with the infection of sporozoite. Due to the infection of the sporozoite into the liver cell, free erythrocytic cycle begin. Exoerythrocytic cycle begins with the infection of cryptozoite into the hepatocyte. At the end of the free erythrocytic cycle, what are the daughter cells which are releases into sinusoids? Cryptozoid. At the end of the exoerythrocytic cycle, daughter cells which may be releases into the sinusoids of liver are metacryptozoids. Again, so in how many days it is completed means, within 2 days exoerythrocytic cycle is completed. But free erythrocytic cycle is completed within 8 days. Definitely, I want to reveal this once again. Free erythrocytic cycle begins with the infection of the sporozoite into the liver cell. In free erythrocytic cycle, finally, daughter cells which are released, they are said to be as the cryptozoites. Free erythrocytic cycle is completed within 8 days period. But exoerythrocytic cycle begins with the infection of cryptozoite. Infection of cryptozoite. In exoerythrocytic cycle, daughters which are released, they are said to be as the metacryptozoites. This exoerythrocytic cycle is completed within 2 days. Again, metacryptozoites are of two types. Metacryptozoites are of two types. Few are big in size, few are small in size.
big sized metacryptocytes are said to be as the macrometacryptozoids. Big sized metacryptozoids are said to be as the macrometacryptozoids. Big sized metacryptozoids are said to be as the macro. Macro means big in size. Small sized metacryptozoids are said to be as the micro metacryptozoids. Micro means small. Micro means small. If this metacryptozoids are small in size, then they are said to be as the micro metacryptozoite. If this metacryptozoites big in size, they are said to be as the macro metacryptozoites. Again, macro metacryptozoites again infect to hepatocytes to continue some more exoerythrocytic cycles. Macro metacryptozoites again infect the new hepatocyte to continue some more exoerythrocytic cycles, but micro metacryptozoite must be entered into the RBC to begin the erythrocytic cycle wanting. Definitely macro metacryptozoites means big sized metacryptozoites are said to be as the macro metacryptozoites. They must be entered into the hepatocytes to again continue some more exoerythrocytic generations. But micro metacryptozoites means small sized metacryptozoites are said to be as a micro metacryptozoite. They must be entered into the RBC only to begin the erythrocytic cyclone, erythrocytic cycle. Means how the erythrocytic cycle is gets begin? Either with the entry of the cryptozoite, either with the entry of the cryptozoite, or with the entry of the micro metacryptozoite, RBC cycle is gets begin. Definitely this cryptozoite, if it can be entered into the RBC, definitely immediately RBC cycle is gets begin. Otherwise all cryptozoites are entered into the liver cell without entering into RBC, definitely exoerythrocytic cycles are gets going on. Whenever the exoerythrocytic cycle is completed within 2 days, after 2 days definitely micro metacryptozoites are releases. They must be entered into the RBC to gets begin the RBC cycle. Means RBC cycle, RBC cyclone must be begins either with the cryptozoite entering or with the micro metacryptozoite entering.